Hi, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. We're in Minneapolis, Minnesota, and we're just finishing up this house. It was built in 1954 and had a radon level of 3.5. Let's go ahead and take a look and see what's involved in mitigating a home like this. Let's go ahead and head down to the basement. So first here we've got the well room. We've got the front step above this. In most instances, we have to drop a suction point in here, so you can see one here. We'll talk about how we determine that in a little bit, but let's kind of take a look at the basement. So here we've got the living room. We've got a fireplace with footings under that. And then we've got the laundry room over here. Well, let's go take a look at this side of the house. So here we've got a bathroom and then just kind of some more living room. But a couple things to point out with the bathroom. A lot of times the bathtub has what's called a plumbing block out underneath it, and it's open to the soil. So they already had this access panel here, so we just simply took that off, which is nice. And we were able to seal that up. So we just put in some spray foam there because we want to seal those openings to the soil. If we hadn't done that, we would have lost some of our suction here, and the radon system would be pulling a little bit of conditioned air that the homeowner is paying to heat and cool down this hole into the radon system and exhausting it outside, so coming at a higher operating cost. A couple other things to show you here. We've got our test holes here. So I think I've got about 8 of them in this house so far. So we just pulled back a corner of the carpet, drilled a 1/2-inch hole through the slab here, and then we just put this rubber cork in the hole. And this allows us to measure the suction that the radon fan is creating. The key to getting your levels low is to create negative suction under the entire house or vacuum. So this allows us to test and measure how far our systems are reaching and if we need additional suction points. When we're done, we'll fill that hole back in and put the carpet back, and you will never know it was there. So now let's go take a look at some of the other suction points. So our first suction point is here. The reason I chose this location is there's a closet right above us that we ran our pipe up through to get to the attic. But on a house without drain tile like this one, it's clay below the slab and it's really hard to move air through clay. So we want to try to find some settling so we can use that to move air through easier so the fan doesn't have to work so hard. So in this instance, if we back up, we have some plumbing for the kitchen that's above us, and then we have a floor drain there. So I was able to use my metal detector. It's cast iron plumbing, so I was able to use this to trace where that plumbing runs. It just so happens to run right through here. So that's why we put the suction point there. We're into some looser soils because when they lay that plumbing in there, they dig a trench, put the plumbing in, and kind of kick the soil back in so it's not as compacted. So suction point there. So I cored my 5-inch hole through the floor and I took out 20 gallons of clay. After that, I used what's called a pitot tube to apply suction to my suction point. And that tells me if I'm reaching my other test holes and if I need additional suction points. So how this works is it's actually called a pitot tube. We seal this into the hole before this pipe was there. And then I use a shop vac, hook it up here, and then it's got this valve. So I can use this valve to simulate a radon fan, or get that shop back to act more like a radon fan. So after adding this suction point, found we still weren't reaching that well room, and we added the third suction point over there. And then just to mention, our pipe all runs back to towards the closet there, and then the one right above Chris right now goes to the one with the U-tube and our labels and alarm there. And then this third one tees off and comes up over the ceiling here and into the well room. And you'll notice we added a panel here because we've got to secure that pipe every 6 feet horizontally by code. So This is the one that comes into the well room. We've got a valve on here so we can control the flow, but we need all the airflow we can get on this. We're only moving 17 CFM. So here's a couple of our test holes, but we've got some settling here where the old well pipe used to come up through. So that's the well room. We'll go back and show you those micromanometers now. So all of our tubing for our test holes come back to our micromanometers here. And again, this is where we measure the suction that the radon system is creating. So all of our numbers are negative. If we shut off the radon fan, these numbers all go positive, which means the house is sucking radon in. So in a perfect world, if I could have everything sealed and engineer the perfect system, say it was an unfinished basement, and I had access to everything, I would shoot for negative 3 pascals in my furthest, weakest test hole under max depressurization conditions. So max depressurization is turning on the dryer, the bath fans, the hood, all that stuff in the house that's fighting against the radon system and exhausting air. So moving on to the system monitors. First, we've got the audible alarm. So that'll let you know if there's a fan failure. Then we've got our visual manometer here, or it's also referred to as a U-tube. So this is measuring the suction of the radon fan. When the fan's working, the fluid levels will be different like this. If it's not working, they'll be equal at zero. And then just a couple things to mention. This fan is going to cost $116 a year to operate, 107 watts, so about $107 of that 116 goes to power for the fan. The other is our estimated conditioned air loss. And then when the customer gets their post-mitigation results, they can put those here. But radon was around 5 this morning. I fired the fan up a couple hours ago, and we've seen it steadily drop. Right now it's running around 1.9. So we'll go up to the closet and show you that. And then on the way, we can show you some of that clay that we ended up taking out. So we ended up with about, I think, 25 or so gallons. Here's the hole that we cored through the concrete, but it's really hard to move air through this. And then some of it was even kind of a moist clay. But we'll go up and take a look at that closet. So here's where our pipe ended up coming up through. The radon fan is directly above us here, and then it exhausts out through the roof on the back side of the house behind that chimney. So to wrap up, I'm going to do my backdraft test on the natural draft water heater to make sure they don't have carbon monoxide issues. I'm going to clean up, do my Department of Health paperwork. They've got the electrician coming next week that's going to add an outlet and a light in the attic. Also want to make sure that they label the breaker that the radon system is on. If you guys enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. It helps us out a lot. I'm Jesse with American Radon. Thanks for watching.